Hello and welcome to Saptarishi's Astrology YouTube channel. My name is Naveen Bhagat and today I want to discuss something which everyone wants to know about. It's the most important planet in a horoscope. People say that Lagna Lord or AtmaKarka planet, these are the options which people always think about. But there's something which can be very, very important planet, even though it is not the Lagna Lord or not the AtmaKarka. A planet sitting in any house, Lord of any house, can be the most important planet if this planet fulfills one condition, which I want to discuss today. Hi, as I said, today's topic is about the most important planet in a horoscope. And generally, when we say most important planet in horoscope, we think about the Lagna Lord or AtmaKarka in the horoscope. But it is not so. A planet which is not the Lagna Lord, not the AtmaKarka or AmartyaKarka can become the most important planet. I don't deny the fact that Lagna Lord is also important. And AtmaKarka is also very important, but a planet can become the most important planet even though it is not the Lagna Lord, not the AtmaKarka. It is not necessarily that it should be a Trikona Lord or Ninth Lord, or it can be Lord of any house. It can be placed in any house, but it should fulfill one condition, which I am going to discuss today. So when we see a horoscope, we have to decide then which point of this horoscope is the most important point. As we see, the moon's nakshatra or moon degree is very important when we calculate the dasha. But the most important point in a horoscope is not the moon's nakshatra. More than moon's nakshatra, the Lagna degree is the most important point in a horoscope. Nakshatra degree means, suppose someone is Leo Lagna, there are 2-3 people with Leo Lagna. If someone's Lagna rises at 1 degree and others rises at 4 degree or 5 degree or 20 degree, then for both the Leo Lagna, Sun is not the most important planet, not their AtmaKarka. There can be a third planet which will be the most important planet in their horoscope. Depending, it should fulfill the condition that the Lagna degree and the planet closest to the Lagna degree is the most important planet. It can be Rahu Ketu also. It can be 8th Lord or 10th Lord or 6th Lord. It can be Lord of any house, it can be placed in any house, but if a planet is closest to the Lagna degree, that planet becomes the most important planet in a horoscope. There can be one planet, or there can be more than one planet, or more than two planets even. So let's see this condition with example charts, with proofs that it should not necessarily be the Lagna Lord or AtmaKarka Lord, but this planet which is closest to the Lagna degree, the role the planet which is closest to Lagna degree plays in a horoscope, this is unimaginable. You cannot just imagine which kind of role this planet plays in a horoscope. So my most favorite chart I want to start with, it's Mahatma Gandhi's chart. In Mahatma Gandhi's chart, Lagna is Libra, rising at 12 degree. So any planet which is closest to 12 degree is the most important planet. If Lagna here rises at 12 degree, so any planet which is closest to 12 degree will become the most important planet in the horoscope. Sun is 16 degree, but more than Sun, Mercury is closer to Lagna degree. And same way, Rahu is also very close to Lagna degree. Rahu Ketu both. So, in Mahatma Gandhi's horoscope, Mercury, Rahu, Ketu, these three planets are the major planets, the most important planets in his horoscope. Mercury is not even the Lagna Lord, it is the 12th Lord and the 9th Lord. Mercury is Dara Karak, not even the Atma Karak. But Mercury in this horoscope is the most important planet. Again, when we see Mercury is in Lagna, 9th Lord in Lagna, 9th Lord of Dharma in Lagna, in the Rashi of Libra and the Rashi of Balance. So his life was about balancing the Dharma, or which he used to say Ahimsa Parmo Dharma. But when we see the Dasha of these planets, then we get a clue about their importance in the horoscope. In this horoscope, Mahatma Gandhi was born in the Dasha of Mercury, followed by Ketu, and then Rahu Dasha started in 1921 and last till 1939. So in this horoscope, Mercury Dasha, Ketu Dasha and Rahu Dasha will play the major role in the horoscope. If we see, he was born in 1869 and Mercury Dasha ended in 1871. So it was only for almost 2 years, and then Ketu Dasha for 7 years. So early 9 years he was in his childhood, he had gone through the most important dashas of his life. When we read about his childhood in Wikipedia, then we find that his sister used to call him restless as Mercury, either playing or roaming about. So this is the effect of Mercury in his life. Mercury is the closest to Lagna degree. So Mercury's role, the playfulness or the restlessness of Mercury is there in his behavior. And he was born in the Dasha of Mercury, so it was in the early childhood. But when we see that Rahu Dasha was in 1921 to 1939, then we find some very crucial events of his life during that period only, like assuming leadership of the Indian National Congress in 1921 and leading a campaign nationwide was the first event when Rahu Dasha started for Swaraj. Rahu is in Cancer. Cancer is about homeland or comforts in 10th house of Karma. So his karma was because of Rahu, because Rahu is the most important planet in this horoscope. So throughout the Rahu Dasha, his karma was about his homeland, gaining back the right of basic rights to the people of country. Next to it, when we see that Rahu Dasha, when we notice that Rahu, Mercury, Ketu are the most important planet in his horoscope, then we see Rahu Dasha started at 1921. So in Rahu Mahadasha, Mercury's Antardasha should have had some important events in his life. So when we see the events between 1929 to 1933, when in Rahu Mahadasha, Mercury and Ketu's Dasha were going on, we see that Dandi's Salt March was in 1930. It was the most revolutionary thing of that time. And then they had between Mahatma Gandhi and Lord Irwin, they had Gandhi-Irwin Pact, which had in 1931. And again, in 1932, when he was going through the Dasha of Rahu and Antar Dasha of Ketu, these two planets in planetary system are known as outcast planets. And in that period, 1932, Gandhi began a new campaign to improve the lives of the untouchables. Rahu is known as the untouchable. Even Ketu is also known as outcast planet, whom he started referring to as Harijans or the children of the god. This is from the Wikipedia. These events are from the Wikipedia. But see the Dasha and the events. These three planets, Rahu, Mercury, Ketu, are closest to the Lagna degree when we talk about their relationship with the in this horoscope with Lagna degree and the relationship between Rahu, Mercury and Ketu. So again, he fasted in 1932 to protest the voting scheme for their separate. He fasted in 1932 to protest the voting scheme for separate political representation for Dalits. It was also happening in 1932 when he was running through the Dasha of Ketu, the Antar Dasha of Ketu in the Mahadasha of Rahu. So we see that even Rahu Ketu are not the AtmaKarka for him, neither Lagna Lord for him, neither Moon's dispositor. But these three planets had major impact in his life, and in the Dasha of Rahu, all the great revolution had happened in his life. Moving ahead to the second horoscope, which is again my favorite horoscope of Shri K.N. Rao ji. Again, Libra Lagna at 21 degree. Again, Libra Lagna in 21 degree. And again, Mercury here is the most important planet. After Mercury, there are Sun, Jupiter and Mars. These are 24 degree. And Mars is also at 24 degree. Saturn is also at 24 degree. But the closest is Mercury. If we take the importance of Mercury in his life, we have to see the Dasha, when he got the Dasha of Mercury, to understand the major effect of Mercury in his life. We know Mercury is the Karaka of Jyotish. Mercury is the Karaka of accounts. He was accounts general in Government of India. He is an astrologer, a far brilliant astrologer of many of us, well known in foreign countries because Mercury is in the 12th house, well known in government circle because Mercury is with Sun. So in his life, Mercury Dasha was from 1986 to 2003. And during that period, if we see his achievements, he started Bharati Vidya Bhavan in 1987. And the Dasha of Mercury started in 1986. So Mercury's Dasha is started a very reputed institution for astrology. And then in 1993, first time he was the chief guest to the second conference of the American Council of Vedic Astrology in 1993. He was again invited, but he refused to attend, or he did not attend for some reasons. But these are the impact of Mercury's Dasha. That was the period when he had written most of his books. And the third horoscope, again my favorite horoscope of my Jyotish Guru. In this horoscope, Lagna is Gemini and rising at 19 degree 23 minutes. The closest planet, Moon, is also very closer to Lagna degree. Then Jupiter is the closest to Lagna degree. Closer than even Moon is 17 degree and Jupiter is 18 degree. And in this horoscope, Jupiter is in the 8th house. So his whole life is all about bringing rare knowledge out in Jyotish. And then Moon is in the 3rd house, which is again the most important planet, and in the house of writing, in the house of communication, So he communicated all the hidden knowledge from villages, from rare astrologers to the masses, to the public. And that way we can see that even Jupiter is not the AtmaKarka, her son is the AtmaKarka, but Jupiter's role in his life is more important, is more, as we can see that Jupiter's role in his life is more important than and more visible than the role of AtmaKarka's son. And again, Moon, his role, we can see that is from the Moon. He communicate, he wrote books about astrology, even the rare secrets of astrology he had given out to people. So these are the three horoscopes I wanted to show you with this technique, that even the Lagna Lord is not so important, or the AtmaKarka is not so important in horoscope as the planet which is closest to the Lagna degree in a horoscope. In a nativity, any planet which is closest to Lagna degree is the most effective planet, is the most powerful or most important planet in that horoscope. This is all from my side. Thank you so much for watching the video.